Hi, God bless you. This is your brother Ferdinand, and I'm recording this in Maryland in the US, and you can see it's winter, and it's been snowing here for the last 2-3 days, and it reminds me of the scripture that we have been looking at, the fact that the future comes in seasons. You see, we've been looking at the future series, and it's important that you secure the future. And you don't secure the future when the future arrives. You secure the future ahead of the future. In fact, Joel Barker, who is one of those guys, he's done a lot of work on paradigms. It's called the futurist. Joel Barker says, the primary responsibility of a leader is to secure the future. So for you to secure the future, you have to understand that the future comes in seasons. And this is true even in the world of business. Every businessman knows that every day, if you are in the stock market, for instance, you know that it's not a bear run every day or a bull run every day. There are times when you have the bulls, then sometimes you have the bears. But how do people like Warren Buffett and other investors, how do they make their billions? Because they have mastered the seasons. When the bulls are running, they know what to do. When the bears are out in the market, they know what to do. When some people are running away, they are running into the fray. So the point I'm making here is that Genesis 8:22 is a major key for life and for victory, no matter what the future brings. And the key to it is to understand that the future comes in seasons. There are seasons of life. Genesis 8:22, the Lord was speaking concerning Noah's sacrifice after the flood. And the Lord said, while the earth remains, seed time and harvest, cold and heat, winter and summer, and then day and night will never cease. And I want to focus on that winter and summer. If you look now, you can see that it is winter. And can you just step around here a bit? You can see there's a beautiful sunlight coming up out there. But the point is that this is winter. Thank you so much. This is winter. But you see, winter and summer, look at the pears. In the weeks ahead, I hope to deal with some of those pears. Seed time and harvest. So there is a season that must be seed time. And there's a season when harvest comes. Then there's a season where you have cold and you have heat. And then there is winter and then there is summer. So you see, imagine now, I asked my friend, how do the animals survive in something like this? It's cold. It's really cold. And he explained to me how they adapt. Some of them burrow into the ground. So what it means is that they must gather their meat, their food in summer. That's why you read about the ants that gather their food in summer. Now, what if the ants had not prepared for winter by gathering in summer? What's going to happen? Then the winter is going to catch them by surprise. And you know how feeble they are, all of them are going to die off. So the key is to use the summers of life. Summer is a season of opportunity. The sun is shining. You know, you don't need to wear all this stuff that I'm wearing. It's a time to walk. In the book of Proverbs, the Bible says, he who gathers in summer is a wise son. But the one that sleeps in harvest is a son that causes shame. So, gathering in summer, there are actions you take in summer that secure winter. So that by the time winter arrives, because of the things you've done in summer, you are ready for winter. When you read about the virtuous woman in Proverbs chapter 31, the Bible says her children, her family, they are not afraid of winter. Why is that so? Because she has made preparations in summer. I want to ask you, are you able to read the present seasons of your life? What season are you in? Some people think that there will always be money pouring into the account every day. It doesn't always work like that. But if you use the season of abundance wisely, you will make investments that will sustain abundance, even in winter. And when winter comes, remember that winter will not last forever. That's why it's a season. And that's not to say that if God is blessing you, it's not going to last. The blessing can be sustained by wise action in the season. that God has granted to you. So that when seasons change, when things are look contrary, the Bible says, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. When seasons change, you will be ready for those seasons because you are connected with the one that holds the seasons in his hands, and you have taken wise action in a favorable season. So understanding this principle will not allow you to be confused or to be distraught or to be hopeless, because you know that there will be a change in the name of Jesus. And in the book of Daniel, Daniel said he changes the times and the seasons. God can change times and seasons, but seasons will be normal as long as earth remains. But when we are connected to the God that changes times and seasons, we can walk in unbroken victory as we take wise action. So maximize summer, and even in winter, the blessing of God will swallow the negative effects or the chill and all the confusions that come and the difficulties that come at such a time. In Jesus' name, Heavenly Father, help us to maximize summer, to make preparations for winter. Help us to take wise, prudent action that will sustain your favor, your blessing, your increase, and your enlargement upon our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. And there's a snowman here. Did you see? There's a little snowman that the children were making, and it is really beautiful outside here. The Lord bless you and keep you in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye-bye.